Hello, this is Eric Bobrow. In this short video walkthrough, I'll show you how to integrate the resources I've created and shared for my Design Views tutorial series. You'll see that there are a number of videos that I've laid out here. Several have been created already and the other ones are in process. You'll see the first one here, how to create simplified drawings and sketch style drawings from your model, whether you're in the early stages or actually well developed, when you want to just meet with the client and show them something simple, and how to do rendered elevations in site plans, where you would have the same elevation and section markers but be able to show them in different styles using some of ArchiCAD's more recently added graphic overrides and model view options. Other tutorials that will be coming up will be showing framing and a variety of different ways that you can look at your model using the view settings and different element attributes. So let's get started with importing this. I'm going to be demonstrating this in a standard ArchiCAD 22 file. This one was created with the US template, the USA template. The process should be the same if you have an international template. You'll just use a different set of files for the import. Now, you can see I've just got a very simple building here. If we go to 3D, nothing too special about it. I'm going to go and give the roof just a little bit of detail so we can see better what's going on with the graphic override. So I'll make the top here have an override and we'll give this a shingle pattern there. And now let's rotate around to the front side here so that we can sort of see what's going on. Now, if we bring up an elevation here, let's say the south elevation, we're seeing a construction document style view because elevation marker settings are such that it's only generating things with a uniform pen color. In this case, in fact, there's no pen. This is all transparent. What I'm going to do is change this to have shaded or non-shaded surface colors, so it'll start having some color. And I'm going to also add in some sun shadow here. And when I say OK, you'll see how it develops. So this is the beginning of doing a rendered elevation, but we don't have any way of changing this directly in the standard environment to take off the shading and to take off the shadows and the hatching. And that's one of the things that we'll be importing in a moment. We'll be looking at a variety of other things that you can quickly import into your environment using the resource pack that you have downloaded. So let's see how that works. We're going to go to the options menu and import the attributes that are set up in this Design Views tutorial series. They actually come from Master Template, my startup kit for ArchiCAD. Now, the Attribute Manager is available directly under the Options menu here. In some versions of ArchiCAD, you may have a submenu called Element Attributes, and off to the side, you'll see Attribute Manager. When you're using Attribute Manager, you'll see a variety of things that you can work on. You can work on layers and pens and fills and etc. You can also go to All. Now, the All mode is not particularly useful just to sort of look at things because it just is a very, very, very long list of all of these things. But when I import using this little import button here or open the element attributes from my Design Views pack, we can then see that this has got a whole lot of things that I've shared with you. Now, in order to import them all, I can go and click on one of them, then do Command A or Control A, or shift click, scroll down to the bottom and shift click to select all of them. Now, I'm going to bring them in by index. That means that they'll use their original index numbers and their references to other things, like surfaces will reference fills and building materials will reference surfaces and fills. They will use the index numbers. So the index numbers will stay constant, the ones that I've added here, and anything that's sort of built into the standard environment, say for fills, it'll use the correct index. So this is the simplest way to import all of these at once. We say OK. Now we'll say go ahead, apply and close. Now we don't see any change here because I haven't actually changed the walls or changed anything in the model. But let's go back to the floor plan and select, I'll just zoom in a little bit, we'll select the walls. So it's Command A or Control A with the wall tool active, we'll select them. And then I'll switch from, in this case, a composite to a complex profile and use one of the profiles that was added. You can see a bunch of them that were added in here from the resource pack. Now I'm going to go and grab this one that has framing and insulation, and you can see that now we have some soft fiber insulation displayed here. Now in 3D, if I go to 3D, it won't look much different. The wall may be a little bit thicker or change a little bit internally. If we go to a section, for example, like this, we'll see the wall comes in with all of its framing. So just with that simple import of the element attributes, you now have, for example, a complex profile that you can study here for how framing is done. And if I go click on this, you'll see that the framing is done with a little trick where each one of these pieces of lumber is actually made of four different triangles, and that's how this is actually generated in the framing system. It's the best way that I've found out to work with it. Now let's go to the floor plan again, and we'll just do a little cutaway and we'll see how this works here. So if I rotate around for the cutaway, you can see that we have the same framing visible right here in the cutaway. So importing the element attributes is certainly giving you some resources that you can experiment with and learn and work with in your own environment. Now let's look at some of the overrides, the graphic overrides and graphic effects. So if we go to that south elevation here, we'll see that we've got the shaded view with all this detail. Let's import the, under the document menu, graphic override combinations. So graphic overrides can be used to change the appearance of your drawings or your 3D views. These are the ones that are standard in the US version. I'm going to go and import from the resource pack the graphic overrides in the graphic overrides folder, and I can select all of them to import at once and just click open, and you can see very, very quickly they show up. Now the one that's highlighted right now is the first one of the new ones here, and when I say OK, you'll see this change. Now it doesn't have any color, so it's no shading. If I go no shading or shadow, which is one of the new ones that were imported, we can see how that works. So I've got all of these effects that I demonstrated in the tutorial here. Now if I do presentation elevation sketchy, we're going to see, you know, a rather sketchy sort of effect. Now the level of detail that we're seeing here for the doors and windows can be changed as well, but that's done through the model view options. So here is the little icon for opening up the model view options, and the model view options, these are the standard ones in the US version. I'm going to go import the model view options for presentation purposes that I supply in the resource pack and say open them, and you'll see them show up in the lower section here under presentations. Let's just switch to presentation here. When I click OK, it'll make that active, and we'll see that we no longer have the opening direction indicated. That's one option for presentation. We can make it simpler by doing presentation schematic, and now we have less detail. So for a sketchy type of presentation view, we can do that. Or presentation site plan is sort of a little bit in between. Doesn't have the line work on it there. Let's just see. I think it's slightly different, you can see, than the main presentation one. So you now have the combinations there. If we go back to the floor plan here, we can see that the floor plan is still set with the original graphic overrides and model view options. If I switch here to presentation, that's going to turn off the markers. If I switch to presentation schematic, that's going to make the doors and windows much simpler. Now that's affecting the door and windows, the doors and window, their symbols as well as their markers. But to make the wall look simpler, we can switch now to, for example, presentation simplified drawing, which will just make a very simple shape here. Or we can do presentation sketchy lines like this. Sketchy lines 2. These are all variations that you may find useful there. So there you have it in terms of the import of these different options for your environment. If you're in the international version, you'll import a different set of files, but the same process will be effective. If you are using a template that's based on some other standards, then there may be some other things that need to be adjusted. I didn't show you in 3D. Let's just show how in 3D, if I go, let's just take and show all in 3D and zoom out here. So there are some overrides here, for example, in terms of the see-through exteriors, additional ones for see-through walls. You can see how the doors and windows are opaque, or see-through walls, doors, and windows. You can see through all of those. So these are some options here that may need some adjustment based on the layer combinations, because the see-through walls, or let's say see-through exteriors, is, if we go to see-through walls exterior, it's based in part on the layer of the wall. Now the layer here, actually, these walls shouldn't be on this layer. This should be set to the A walls exterior in order to only make the exterior walls transparent. And so now I edit that, and you can see this is now working in terms of showing through all of the exterior walls. And if you had walls on the inside, they would actually still be solid. So that's an interesting presentation option. Now, if you have any doubts about whether it's going to work in your environment, I suggest that you import these attributes and graphic overrides and model view options into a copy of one of your files and experiment with it before you import it into a real working file, of course. If you have any questions or comments, please send them to me, email me at support@bobrow.com, or post your comments below this video. Now, if you'd like to turbocharge your entire ArchiCAD working environment, going beyond what I can share here in this tutorial series with the different view styles, I suggest that you check out Master Template. All of these view styles were developed and refined in the context of Master Template, which is a very powerful startup kit for ArchiCAD projects. It not only has these elements, but it has a huge sets of schedules and views in the view map that make your work go faster, layouts that are preset with just a whole lot going on. Before you even start a project, you've got sort of half of your organization already done. So check out Master Template if you would like to work with ArchiCAD faster and get higher quality output. Happy to answer any questions about Master Template. Just email me or make a comment or post on this page. It's been my pleasure to share this with you, and I appreciate your interest in my work and in these tutorials, and I wish you the best with your ArchiCAD work as you move through the coming years. This has been Eric Bobrow. Thanks for watching.